To create a new term or new category, first open the Business Glossary. Terms are the building blocks that make up the collection of business concepts, words, or phrases in a business glossary. Terms are organized into logical classifications called categories. A term can be part of one or more categories, and terms can be linked to one another. To create a new term, click the Create button and select Term. Enter the term name. Optionally, you can add an abbreviation. Terms are searchable by their abbreviations in Content Search. Status shows the approval state of the term. The glossary steward is responsible for moving the term from draft to verified, and the term status can also be changed to deprecated. A deprecated term will remain in the glossary where it can also be deleted. The definition should be a short description of the term in business language that users understand. The related information field allows for more information related to the term. For example, links to external information, how this definition was created, help about usage of the term, etc. Glossary terms can be linked to apps and data sets that are available to the user in the current Qlik Cloud environment. The term editor selects these resources to link the term to related supporting content. In related terms, you can relate glossary terms to one another, and you can link them together with term relationships. The nature of the relationship between terms is specified by setting how the term relates to the linked term. In the Term Stewards field, you can add individuals responsible for this term. This field is informational. Individuals selected are saved to this field and are not given any additional permissions or privileges. In Categories, you can select one or more categories under which this term will be included. In Tags, you can apply meta tags to define and organize this term. The term is now created and will be available in the Business Glossary. To create a category, click the Create button and select Category. In the Name field, add a category name. Categories are folder directories arranged logically to reflect how a user may search for information in a business glossary. In the Category Stewards field, add the individuals responsible for this category. This property is similar to Term Steward and is informational only. Individuals selected and saved to this field are not given any additional permissions or privileges. In Parent Category, select a category that will be the parent of this nested category. These relations between categories help to build the mapping and structure of the business glossary. In this case, we want to create a main category, and we want to add subfolders to this category. When building category hierarchies, our practical approach is to break down larger concepts into smaller ones. In this case, we have created a travel insurance category, and we want to include subcategories to specify different types of coverage. For example, trip cancellation insurance or baggage and personal item loss. Since we want to include this category under travel insurance category, we select it from the parent category drop-down menu. When done, we are going to create another category for the baggage and personal item loss, and, as before, we add it as a subcategory of the travel insurance category. And here you have the final result. You now have the travel insurance category that includes the baggage and personal item loss category, and the trip cancellation category. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.